As the world celebrates World Meteorological Day on March 23rd, the theme for this year, the ocean, our climate and weather, has never been more relevant. The ocean is a major driver of the world's weather and climate, as well as global economy. It also plays a central role in climate change. Today, the growing impacts of climate change are making ocean observations, research and services more critical than ever before. DOI spoke to Vidya Sondarajan, Director of Ecological Footprint, and Vinod Malayiletu, Team Leader of Marine Conservation Programs from WWF India, to understand why the oceans are such an integral part of our planet.
One meter sea level rise vertically, it doesn't seem really bad, but 1 meter sea level rise horizontally translates to something like 850 to a kilometer of sea coming inside the land. So we see, you know, Kerala not receiving so much rain, but western Gujarat and western Rajasthan receiving, because our southwest monsoon's trajectory has shifted by 200 odd kilometers. And that means East Godavari district, Cherrapunji, other places which used to receive that line, you know, of rain is not receiving anymore. That means, you know, your agriculture suffers, desert is receiving rain, the rainforest is not receiving any rain at all, it's becoming drought. So the, you know, it's like a domino effect. There are three very, very big impacts that will happen. One, of course, is the land erosion and losing of the coastal land itself. A lot of fishing communities, people, you know, a big chunk of our population is on the coast. That's going to be a huge impact. The other is the frequency and the intensity of cyclones and disasters is going to increase. The number of times cyclones will hit and cause destruction and damage is both going to be more in number and much higher in intensity and causing huge damages and to the point of existential damage. The third impact is, you know, basically on the livelihood, where there is sort of the population is decreasing and, you know, you're not able to, the salinity impacts, the prawn, you know, the spawning population and all of that impacts. So, you know, so there is the secondary, tertiary, third level impact also. The World Meteorological Day this year is also focusing on engaging youth. You know, in the last decade, there has been a lot of talk going on about climate change. And to a certain extent, now the future generation has started putting the pressure on our generation, on our, you know, the policymakers of our age and decision makers and the leaders of our age to act fast. So that they can at least have a livable world. You know, they don't inherit a world that is not livable at all. So they have huge stakes. Coastal communities and the communities on high altitude mountains as the climate frontiers. They are at the front end, they are at the receiving end of the climate impact. So whether it is sea level rise, whether it is cyclonic storms, whether it is land erosion, you know, and destruction, floods, they are going to face a lot more. And, you know, and also our socioeconomic data shows that fishing community is one of the most poor already. And on top of it, you add a layer of climate vulnerability. So, you know, entire populations become extremely vulnerable.
Certain endangered, threatened and protected species, for example, the marine turtles. So as Vidya was mentioning, when there's a sea level rise, the beach gets inundated. So that means the animal doesn't have a space to like nest. So that means you are losing that specific ecosystem, and also the same is with regard to mangroves. So when you have inundation, the mangroves also get submerged. So that is another impact. We have the Wildlife Protection Act. So in the Wildlife Protection Act, there are fish and other species which are protected under the Wildlife Protection Act. So that has the whales, sharks, marine turtles, sea cucumbers. So all those species are protected. So there is already a law that is in place to protect these species.
From the climate change perspective also, there is the coastal zone regulation management, you know, so it has been revised recently. The wetlands guidelines has been revised recently, specifically looking at mangrove wetlands and further protection. So Government of India is actually doing, you know, putting in considerable effort in terms of diversifying the activities that can be in works that can be included under MGNREGA, which is your, you know, social protection scheme, so that those livelihoods can be protected. Specifically, Government of India has what is known as the National Adaptation Fund, where state governments can bid for money to build the climate resilience of either communities or ecosystems or, you know, water, multiple issues such as that. So at three levels, at legal level, at a policy and scheme level, and at a financial level, there are various steps that are being taken.
This year's World Meteorological Day also marks the starting year of the United Nations Decade of Ocean Science for Sustainable Development from 2021 to 2030. As conservation continues to be a buzzword for the coming decade, it is more imperative than ever to understand the fragile ecosystem between humans, animals, and the ocean. TOI On and Report.